After discussing the topics of conduction and convection in the previous two sections, let's talk about the third and final mode of heat transfer, radiation. Radiation is the transfer of heat energy between two bodies at different temperatures that occurs in the form of electromagnetic waves. Since these electromagnetic waves do not need a medium to travel, radiation occurs even when there is no solid or fluid material medium present. If we stand directly under the sun, we feel warm. This is because heat energy from the sun reaches our body through radiation. As mentioned before, unlike conduction and convection, radiation does not require any intermediate medium. Hence, heat energy from the sun can travel through the vacuum of space to reach Earth. Another example of radiation in our daily lives is the toaster oven. Here, heat radiated from the heater coils toasts the slice of bread. So now let's look at how this radiation process is modeled mathematically. A simplified form of the equation describing radiation from one surface to another is given by this formula. Here, Qij is the radiated heat energy that is transferred from surface I to surface J. Let's take a moment to discuss the terms that contribute to radiated heat. Epsilon is the emissivity of the surface, which is a measure of the amount of thermal radiation emitted by the surface. Fij is known as the view factor between the surfaces. The view factor is the fraction of the total radiant energy that leaves surface I, which arrives directly at surface J. We will discuss emissivity and view factor in more detail shortly. Ti and Tj are the surface temperatures in absolute units. It is important to note that we always use the absolute scale, that is Kelvin or degree Rankine, when modeling radiation. For everything else in thermal simulations, say phase change or conduction or convection, we can use any temperature scale. But for radiation, calculations must be performed in an absolute scale. Last but not least, sigma is the Stefan-Boltzmann constant, having a value of 5.67 e to the power minus 8 watt per meter square Kelvin to the power 4. This is a physical constant formulated in the late 19th century by two physicists from which the constant takes its name, and it can be thought of as converting the absolute temperature to heat intensity. All materials having temperature greater than absolute zero emit thermal radiation. Based on the radiation equation, we can see that the radiant energy exchange is directly proportional to the fourth order of the absolute temperature of the two surfaces. This has two implications. Not only does the amount of heat radiated between two surfaces depend on the temperature difference between them, but it also depends on their absolute temperature. Let's take a simple example of two objects with a difference of 20 degrees Celsius, but consider two cases. One, when the two objects are 20 and 40 degrees Celsius, and another case when they are at 500 and 520 degrees Celsius. Although the temperature difference is only 20 degrees between the two cases, we see that the radiated heat between them is close to 20 times different. Previously, in case of conduction and convection, we typically considered only the temperature difference between surfaces. However, in the case of radiation, we take the absolute temperature to the fourth power, then look at the difference. Thus, even though the temperature difference is the same, the use of absolute temperature to the fourth power is an important point concerning radiated heat. As was the case with convection, we will be modeling radiation as a boundary condition in the conduction-based solver that we use in this course. Now let's look at how different bodies or materials behave when subjected to incident thermal radiation. When a certain amount of thermal radiation is incident on a surface, part of it will be reflected, part of it will be absorbed, and the rest of it may be transmitted through the body. The fraction of the incident thermal radiation that is transmitted by a body is known as the transmissivity tau. The fraction that is absorbed by the body is known as absorptivity alpha. And the fraction that is reflected by the body is known as its reflectivity rho. Since these three components are fractions of the incident radiation, they always add up to 1. Based on these three components, the behavior of a body or a material can be characterized. If a body does not transmit any incident radiation, that is, if the transmissivity is equal to 0 and the absorptivity and reflectivity are non-zero, then the body is said to be opaque. Conversely, if a body transmits all the incident radiation, that is when the transmissivity is 1 and the other two components are 0, the body is said to be transparent. If a body absorbs all the incident radiation, that is its absorptivity is 1 and the other two components are 0, then that body is called a black body. Conversely, if a body reflects all the incident radiation in a uniform manner in all directions, it is called a white body. Black body and white body are idealized physical states which are not found in nature. But mirror-like metallic surfaces reflect radiation well and are closer to a white body. For example, aluminium foil reflects most of the incident radiation and hence is closer to a white body. Asphalt, on the other hand, absorbs most of the incident radiation and hence is closer to a black body. Let's take a moment to discuss the concept of a black body in more detail, as it can be useful to understand emissivity, which we saw appear in the radiation equation earlier. A black body absorbs all incident radiation while reflecting or transmitting none. Hence, it is the perfect absorber. A close idealization of a black body could be a cavity with opaque walls which has a small hole in it. In this case, once an incident wave enters the cavity through the small hole, it is either absorbed or reflected. Any reflected component of the radiation hits another surface of the cavity and part of it gets absorbed. This process of absorption and reflection continues, trapping the incident radiation inside the body till it is completely absorbed. Since the chance that a fraction of the reflected radiation will leave through the same opening is very small. For thermal equilibrium, that is, if the black body has to stay at a constant temperature, it has to emit thermal radiation at the same rate that it absorbs it. Hence, a black body is also a perfect emitter. While we haven't proven this point yet, the emissivity is the same as the absorptivity for a black body, which is 1. Now, real surfaces in nature fall somewhere in between black and white bodies. Such surfaces are called grey bodies. Gray bodies may transmit, absorb, and reflect the radiation incident on them. That is, they may have non-zero transmissivity, absorptivity, and reflectivity, which together add up to 1. It is important to consider the absorptivity, reflectivity, and transmissivity of different materials in the design process. For example, when designing a solar thermal conversion system, it is critical to choose collector materials which have high absorptivity and hence can absorb most of the incident radiation. As noted earlier, any body with temperature greater than absolute zero or 0 Kelvin will emit radiation. The amount of thermal radiation emitted by a body depends on its surface property called emissivity. Emissivity is defined as the ratio of the energy radiated from a material surface to the energy radiated from a black body surface under the same conditions, that is, at the same wavelength, temperature, and viewing conditions. Emissivity is a dimensionless quantity. For a body to be in thermal equilibrium, the emissivity of a body is equal to its absorptivity. Thus, surfaces which are good absorbers of thermal radiation are also good emitters. At first glance, it may seem strange to think of emissivity and absorptivity to be the same for a body in thermal equilibrium. But the concept of a black body introduced earlier has helped us understand this point. Thus, while we only saw emissivity in the radiative heat flow rate equation shown in the beginning of this lesson, we can now understand emissivity and absorptivity to be the same for our purposes. Emissivity depends on a number of factors such as the material and nature of the surface, its temperature, and the wavelength and direction of the radiation. For example, a polished mirror-like surface has a lower emissivity as compared to a rough surface, since a polished surface reflects most of the radiation instead of absorbing it. From this table here, we see that different materials have different emissivity. But apart from bare polished metals, the general color or appearance of a surface is not a good way to estimate its emissivity. For example, pure water absorbs very little visible light and hence may appear transparent, but it is a very good absorber of infrared radiation. Hence, water has a high emissivity despite its transparent appearance. In addition, emissivity may also depend on the direction. If a surface emits the same amount of radiation in different directions, then the surface is known as a diffuse surface. On the other hand, if the radiation emitted by a surface changes with direction, then the surface is known as specular surface. Another factor affecting emissivity is the wavelength of the radiation. In case of opaque surfaces, the emitted radiation and hence emissivity may vary with wavelength. A spectral distribution plot shows the variation of emitted radiation with wavelength. Lastly, emissivity may also depend on temperature. For example, the emissivity of certain aluminium alloy was found to reduce from 0.3 to 0.1 when its temperature was increased from 600 Kelvin to 800 Kelvin. So now we know how to differentiate between opaque and transparent radiation, between diffuse and specular radiation, and we also learned what the terms black body, white body, and gray body mean. In this course, we will talk about opaque, gray, diffuse radiation. That is, the bodies considered here cannot transmit any radiation, and their surfaces are diffuse surfaces which emit or reflect radiation in all directions in a similar manner. As discussed before, since we are using a conduction-based solver in this course, radiation will be modeled as a boundary condition.